Good day to everyone. Today let's see how to find the speed or the RPM of an induction motor. Here what you see is the stator of an induction motor. There are two poles, or rightly speaking, one pair of poles fitted vertically inside of the stator. These are called poles because when you wind a coil around it and make current to flow through it, it will act as a magnetic pole, creating a magnetic field around it. Fix another pair of poles inside of the stator like this, and we'll arrange our windings on it too. Let's arrange the rotor of the motor in between pole pairs. Small circles shown on the rotor indicates cross sections of conductors on it. Now it is a four-pole motor, or a motor with two pole pairs. When coil is energized with flowing current, magnetic field is created in between pole pairs, making one north end, and the other end being the south. This magnetic field produces magnetic flux, which flows from north to south always. Initially, we need to create a rotating magnetic field in order to rotate the rotor of the motor. Three-phase motors, of course, automatically produce this rotating magnetic field, since its line voltages pulsate with 120 degrees angle difference. If red line of three phases reaches peak value on its sinusoidal waveform at some point, then yellow line reaches its peak value at a point 120 degrees later. Likewise, the third phase of blue reaches its maximum value after another 120 degrees later. So it makes a rotating magnetic field on the direction of RYB. Single phase motors also produce rotating magnetic field, but need to have a capacitor at the start to produce the additional phase needed with different angle to start the rotation of the magnetic field. When the conductors on rotor cut the magnetic flux on the rotating magnetic field, current is generated on the conductors. This current produces torque, which is a rotating moment, and acts perpendicular to the conductors on the rotor. Result is, the rotor too starts rotation and follows the rotating magnetic field on the same direction. Generally, speed of rotating magnetic field is called as synchronous speed of a motor. You will realize now, when rotor reaches the synchronous speed, there won't be any current flow on conductors, since those are not cutting the flux lines any further. There won't be any torque to drive the rotor now, and rotor speed will decrease till it starts cutting the magnetic flux lines again. In practice, rotor tends to run a little slower than the synchronous speed to make sure that there will be a driving torque on its conductors always, to have a near fixed speed of rotation on the rotor. This speed difference in between the rotor and the rotating magnetic field is known as the slip of the motor. Let's see what is the frequency of the supply voltage is really meant by. Frequency is the number of voltage waveforms or cycles repeated in a time period of 1 second. If the black dot you see here is the value of voltage at that angle, values of the voltage related to the angle in a cycle is shown here repeating for 8 cycles. Further, we take RMS value of voltage for calculations instead of the repeatedly changing voltage values in a cycle, and is shown here in the graph acting in a straight line. Although you will see only 8 numbers of 360 degree cycles performed here, supply frequency of 50 Hz means that 50 numbers of similar voltage sine wave cycles repeat within a time period of 1 second. Please note that, in North America including USA, the supply RMS voltage is 120 volts, and the frequency is 60 Hz, where in Europe and most of other countries, have 230 volts of RMS voltage, with the frequency of 50 Hz. Let's see how the north and south poles change when the voltage sine wave advances in a cycle. Here, it's a motor with minimum pair of poles, that is one pair of poles. When current flow through the windings, north pole changes to a south pole and become a north pole again, within one voltage cycle. If you mark the north pole like this here, you will clearly see that the magnetic field rotates one complete circle of 360 degrees within one voltage cycle. Let's consider a motor with four poles, have a winding arrangement on all poles like this. There are different kinds of winding arrangements, but I have taken this particular arrangement to show how the rotating magnetic field speed changes with the inclusion of additional pole pairs to the motor. When voltage sine wave completes one full cycle here, magnetic field rotates half of a circle only. For the magnetic field to rotate the full turn of 360 degrees, it needs another voltage cycle to perform, and is because of the additional pair of pole introduced to the motor. Further, you will see here, when you double the number of pole pairs of a motor, the speed of rotating magnetic field or the synchronous speed becomes half of the speed of the rotation of voltage cycle. Let's find the speed of a motor now. You got to know this simple equation for calculation work. Synchronous speed or the speed of rotating magnetic field is depending on the frequency of the supply voltage and the number of pole pairs of the motor. Frequency of the supply voltage, that is F in Hertz, equals Ns into P, where Ns is the synchronous speed, and P is the number of pole pairs. Here in this example, it says to calculate the speed of the rotating field of a two-pole motor in revolutions per minute, if the supply frequency is 50 Hz. From the equation given, rotating magnetic field is frequency divided by number of pole pairs. Since two-pole motor has only one pair of poles, you can divide 50 by 1 to get a speed. Further, to convert revolutions per seconds to RPM, need to multiply this by 60 also. It shows that this motor has a rotating magnetic field with a speed of 3000 RPM. If the previous question is changed to a motor with two pole pairs, synchronous speed or the speed of rotating magnetic field is 50 divided by 2. After multiplying it with 60, to convert revolutions per seconds to RPM, you get synchronous speed of 1500 RPM for this motor. You can remember that it was shown earlier, and in practice, rotor tends to run a little slower than the synchronous speed, to make sure that there will be a driving torque on its conductors always, to have a near fixed speed of rotation. This difference in speed between the rotor and the rotating magnetic field is known as the slip of the motor. It is more usual to refer it as fractional slip, which has no dimensions, and is calculated by taking the difference between two speeds and dividing it by the synchronous speed. Since no dimensions involve in slip, you can take all speeds here in this equation, in RPM, or revolutions per seconds. After arranging the two equations related to speed of a motor like this, let's find the answer to the question asked here. It says, to find the fractional slip of a three-phase, four-pole motor, if the supply frequency is 50 Hz, and the rotor speed is 1440 RPM. From the first equation, synchronous speed is 50 divided by 2, and after multiplying it by 60, you get 1500 RPM for synchronous speed. Since N, or the rotor RPM, is 1440, fractional slip S is the difference of speeds divided by 1500. You get 0.04 as the fractional slip of this motor, and is also can be given as percentage slip of 4%. Hope you got fair idea now how the RPM changes when frequency and number of pole pairs are different in an induction motor. If this video is helpful, please subscribe the channel. Thank you.